We are back in Chapultepec on the way to the Castillo because we ran out of time for it yesterday.
Because we got hungry.
And then after that, we're going to go to see Luis Barragan's Estudio. This will be a kind of quick one too. And then we have dinner tonight.
So CNN released a list of the top 50 restaurants in the world. And this restaurant is on that list. I think it's number 27, but I'm very excited.
Okay, this is where the hard part begins. We got to walk up the hill to get to the castle. I forget to record myself these days in my vlog. So it's funny, I've been using my camera bag as a backpack because a little sling over shoulder one just destroys my back. It's been really nice, except it keeps all your heat back here, so it gets really hot, sweaty, but it's kind of easier to carry around. But all these museums look at me funny. They're like, why do you have so much crap with you, man? But they let me take it this time. Sometimes it takes a giant hill for you to remember that Mexico has altitude. Made it up, bought a video ticket as we were talking about, and then we talked to a guy and he's like, can't video without a ticket. And so we're like, yeah, we bought it. And he's like, yeah, but you can't.
He was saying we need to have a stick.
Is it like a press or something?
To put on our camera. And then I told him, well, we paid for it, but she didn't give me a sticker. And then he was like, yeah, you need a sticker. And I was like, all right, I don't think he's listening. So we just left. And he said, okay, thanks. And then, yeah.
Vlogging like really hard, and his girlfriend was doing the recording.
No, I'm not doing.
You know what I just noticed too? And maybe, I think it's on purpose, but like notice how the sidewalks are white and the hedges are green and the flowers are red. I'm curious if that's on purpose. Yes, room and the royal flush. That I have a better understanding of more of the ancient cultures of Mexico, more so than up to modernity. So it was really interesting to get kind of a brief review of what took place up until modern days, early 1900s, after Porfirio Díaz left. Yeah, I wish I just had a little more stuff on the indigenous, basically wrongdoings in short. But they only had like a corner dedicated to the rebellions, which is kind of interesting. But otherwise a very awesome place to visit when you come to Mexico City.
This place was, I forgot what year they built it, but it was meant for government officials and then officially became like the president's home until 1939. And that president decided to turn it into a museum and the president house somewhere else.
So, look at that guy. He's kind of ugly, kind of cute. Yeah. But
I learned Chapultepec, and we're at the castle of Chapultepec, means hill of the grasshopper.
Yeah.
And before the castle was built here, this was like a sacred hill for, I think, the Aztec people. And yeah, and I guess they just kept the name and built the castle. Yeah.
I think the most interesting thing that I found out today was when Emperor Maximilian came by. Oh, hold on, there's a cop. Because the hardest uphills are the easiest downhills, and vice versa. We picked up some more papas con chile de limón and some water.
Agua.
Original Pritzker Prize.
Oh, wow.
And it was designed by Henry Moore. And there is only 9 pieces like this.
dancing my way.
Today and I checked 1,000 times, but I accidentally booked for 2 days ago. So there was an extra ticket, and she let me take it, and it's just hanging out at a mercado close by. But yeah, I'll see if I can get her in here or something. Okay, so where are we going?
We're going to Quintonil, I think that's how you say it. And it's number 27 out of the top 50 restaurants of the world.
And Kai's been looking forward to this since we started talking. Since October. Instagram.
You guys haven't followed my Finsta, food Instagram?
Plug.
It's at kai.nut.eeeats. Kai Nut Eats.
We've got our drinks as well. And What do you think of our from the chef?
It's so good.
Ceviche. Couldn't save it though.
En recado negro, viene acompañado con puré de almendras, la salsa. La salsa es de la misma cocción de la cola, recado negro y además un toque de chile habanero.
Huele bien.
Así que va a sentir un poquito de picor.
Ajá.
¿Okay? Y le dejamos todo.
Two-thirds to three-quarters of the way through our dishes.
I feel lit. I got
oxtail
dish. What did you get?
I got a striped bass, it's kale salad. The dressing is fantastic. And then there's a cauliflower puree that's really interesting as well. So overall, very, very good. Oh yeah, and then vegetable caviar. Very interesting as well. Yeah, very weird.
It's really cold.
What did we just get?
A cactus.
Experience that was so nice to us.
But they were really happy when we were like, oh, let's practice our Spanish. Mm-hmm. Or they asked us if we knew Spanish and we said yes.
Yeah, we just had a really good time. We were able to have fun because of our connection to Spanish and yeah, it was just awesome. Really. The company though, man, oh my goodness, I couldn't just ridiculous. What does this say? What does this button do?
I know, I can't even flip, that's so dumb.
What does that say?
I hate you.
Es interesante porque Polanco es muy diferente que las otras zonas en la ciudad. And I don't know what to say after that, but it's very interesting. Inmediatamente. Y, oh, see what I mean? What the heck is that? Okay, so another funny thing is that we both messed up today. Me worse than her.
I don't know, that was pretty bad.
I already told you guys about what I did, but again, Luis Barragan Museum and house. Our Uber driver's here, but I booked that for 2 days ago instead of today. And then I wrote down in our, I think that's probably
him.
We booked dinner as well, and I had wrote that down in our calendar at 6 p.m. And Kai had been telling me every day that it was 6:30. And sure enough, it's at 6. Well, our Uber took forever to get to us, and it took us 50 minutes to get here, so we were super duper late, but they let us sit down anyway.
These represent the divine in the earth, like a god. Well, Barragán was very Catholic, very religious, but he don't show it in public spaces. He used these elements that represents only.
This chair, that is a bit special.
Oh, yes. a detail.
Yeah.
This is called Miguelito chair. Or Silla Miguelito was designed by Luis Barragán and Clara Porcel. Clara Porcel was a Cuban.
Yeah, I made a chair based off of this chair.
Actually, there is more chairs like this in the house, but different sizes because the scale of the room. Yeah. It's more dark, more quiet.
He changed the floor.
Made this with these low walls and the carpet, and even this piece of art, another Joseph Albert. And well, you see this statue. This sculpture is the Pritzker Prize, the original Pritzker Prize.
Oh, wow.
And it was designed by Henry Moore. And there is only 9 pieces like this. This library, about the 20%, it's about architecture. The rest is about art, landscape design, philosophy, history, music. You can see his travels, African, Japanese.
Yeah, travel.
In this area, Barragan used too much the nostalgia he feels by the hacienda when he was a child, the hacienda of his father, the hacienda. All haciendas have these wood veins. And this thick wall, you can see this thick wall. Well, the haciendas have this because the material is adobe. It's from the ground. But this is only an illusion. This is a normal wall, but the window is extruded. You can see this from the facade, it's a cube shape to the outside. But no, this is a mezzanine. Okay? A mezzanine, we call this in Mexico tapanco. And this is some very used in haciendas for storing some tools or animal food. The space changed completely. It's a darkest place. We call this in Spanish penumbra. Barragán used too much this penumbra for creating atmosphere for his closer friends. Actually, this was the favorite place for Luis Barragán. In his last 10 years, he had Parkinson's disease. So the bed was changed because the white room was turned into the nurse's room. But I never have furniture here and never makes parties here. It's always like sometimes I have a little table and a couple of chairs. Teach me the difficult art to see with innocence. Barragán likes to see the things but with this innocence like a child, okay? Not like a rationalist way. And this painting have elements of the house, like colors, like the religion, have the pink, the yellow, brown, and white. And well, the colors that Barragán would use, at least in this house for painting, is the green and the blue. This is handcrafts from Jalisco, Tonalá and Tlaquepaque. And well, he used it for creating more contrast in the house. All the house is square shape, opacities. And well, you see this big sphere shining. It's blown glass with silver inside.